Hi students, welcome to my lectures on mechanical unit operations. In today's lecture, we are going to learn about calculating terminal settling velocity of a particle. Terminal settling velocity means the final velocity of a particle. Imagine if I drop a stone into a bucket of water, it will flow, it will come down with a certain velocity. The constant velocity with which it is coming to the bottom, right, that is called the terminal settling velocity of the particle. Okay, there is some to derive this terminal settling velocity of a particle, we need to do some force balance. Today we'll take an example that if a particle is settling in a still liquid, what is going to happen? If it is particle is coming down in a liquid, what will be the velocity of that particular particle, which is called terminal settling velocity of a particle. It has many applications. We'll discuss about the applications later. Let us see. And if you see here, the particle which is having certain diameter dp and which is coming with a downward velocity which is called ut, the velocity at which they're coming down, if it is not changing with the time, then that is called the terminal settling velocity of the particle. And as I told you, if a particle is coming down, total three forces that are acting, two upward forces, one downward force. The downward force is the gravity, the two upward forces of one is buoyancy and second one is drag. So that is why when the particle is coming down and the two upward forces, which is caused by the fluid, which is water or any other liquid, FB is the upward buoyancy force, FD is the upward drag force, FG is the gravity force. Okay, and the force balance at constant velocity, the upward forces should be equal to the downward forces. Okay, when a particle is coming with a constant velocity, this condition should happen. Okay, if upward forces are equal to downward forces, the particle velocity will not change. It comes with a very constant velocity. It's like if you are riding a bike, suddenly you are accelerating, you get some jerk kind of feeling to the back. Okay, that means you are changing the velocity of the bike, that is why you get the jerk feeling. Imagine if you are going on a bike with a constant velocity, you will not feel that. Okay, that's called the constant velocity of a bike. Okay, because the forces are balanced over there, that is why you are not going to get that kind of acceleration there. So that is why whenever the upward forces are equal to the downward forces, that means the particle will reach a velocity which is called the constant velocity. In mechanical unit operation terms, it is called terminal settling velocity of a particle. Okay, let us do the force balance. Upward forces equal to downward forces, that's called the force balance. At constant velocity of the particle, if the particle is coming with a constant velocity, the net force on the particle is zero. When you are accelerating, then only you will feel the force. Okay, that way the net force on the particle is zero. When it is going to happen, upward forces are equal to the downward forces. Okay, upward force plus downward force is equal to zero. If we take it as a total equation, the two upward forces are FB and FD, the downward forces is FG. FG is minus because FG is acting opposite to that of FD and FB. So that is why it's a minus. Okay, so FG is negative because the opposite direction of the force. Okay, what is, if you go through, what is FG? MG is the mass of the particle in the gravity. What is F buoyancy? Mass of the water that is displaced because of this particle into the gravity. What is the mass? Is equal to volume of the particle into density of the water. Okay, into G. This is the buoyancy force. FD is equal to CdAP into rho u square ut square by 2. C is the drag coefficient, A is the projected area of the particle. Projected area, if you watch my earlier years, you will understand. Rho is the density of the fluid, ut is the velocity at which the particle is coming down. Okay, if you put everything, if you put 2, 3 and 4 equations into the equation number 1, you get the equation. If you take out all the velocity terms on the one side and the other terms on the another side, you get ut square is equal to 2g into rho p minus rho l into mp into projected area into density of the particle into cd is called drag coefficient into density of the liquid. Okay, this is how this is called if you, this is square, right? If you take ut is equal to square root of this particular term, which is this equation number 5. So the equation number 5 is the terminal settling velocity of the particle. This is the velocity at which the particle will come down if both forces are got balanced. Okay, and let us simplify. For a spherical particle, what is the AP? Projected area of the particle. Okay, imagine a sphere that is coming down. Okay, which area will be projected here? A circle area will be projected if it is coming down. So what is the that is why AP, if you substitute AP is equal to pi d square by 4, the area of the circle, and mass of the particle, if you replace volume of the particle into density, volume is equal to pi d cube by 6, volume of the particle if it is a sphere, and into d rho p, put 6 and 7 in equation number 5, you get terminal settling velocity of a spherical particle. So what is spherical particle? Square root of 4g into rho p minus rho l into dp by 3 times cd into rho l. Okay, now different regimes will come. As long as you don't know cd, which is the drag coefficient, because similar to the friction factor, here it's called drag coefficient. And if you do know the cd, you can able to evaluate terminal settling velocity of the particle. But the cd value depends on the Reynolds number of the particle. If Reynolds number is less than 1, particle Reynolds number, it's not a pipe Reynolds number. When pipe Reynolds number is less than 1, it comes under the Stokes law regime. If this is the case, cd equal to 24 by Reynolds number of the particle. What is the Reynolds number of particle? Is dp, diameter of the particle, into velocity of the particle, into density of the liquid, divided by viscosity of the liquid. If you substitute here, you get cd equal to 24 into mu l dp ut rho l. Simply you substitute that cd in the equation number 8 and you cancel out the terms, you get final velocity, which is called ut is equal to g dp square into rho p minus rho l into 18 times mu l. This is called the terminal settling velocity of a spherical particle in Stokes law regime. This is called the Stokes law. And second, if Reynolds number, if it is Reynolds number is higher, okay, then it, if cd equal to 0.44 in the Newton's law regime, when we are turning from laminar to a bit turbulent conditions, the drag coefficient cd is a constant, which is 0.44. If you substitute equation number 12, which is cd, in equation number 8, you get ut is equal to 4/3 g. Simply we have substituted in place of cd, we put 0.44, you get final equation. Okay, the final equation is 1.75 into square root of g dp rho p minus rho l by rho l. Okay, this law is a Stokes law. This called, it's a Newton's law, because depending upon the flow conditions, whether it's a laminar conditions or turbulent conditions. Here technically people will skip whether it is in Stokes law regime or Newton's law regime. Depending upon the regime the particle is, we use the specific equations. If it is a Stokes law regime, use this equation to calculate the velocity. If it is Newton's law regime, use this equation to calculate the velocity. Let us go to the board and a few examples. Here is the terminal settling is a problem. Find the terminal settling velocity of a 40 micron size particle which is having the specific gravity of 2.6 falling through a still water. That means there is no turbulent conditions, laminar conditions are there. Assume the particle falls in Stokes law regime. Given these conditions, we have to find out what is the velocity of the particle that is coming down in a liquid. Okay, given diameter is equal to 40 micron, which is 40 into 10 power minus 6 meter, viscosity 10 power minus 3 Pascal second. Pascal second is nothing but kg per meter second. Specific gravity is 2.6. What is the specific gravity? Density of the particle, the density of the water is equal to 2.6. Then what is the density of the particle? Is 2.6 times the density of the water, which is 2.6 into 1000, that is 2600 kg per meter cube. And density of the water, okay, is 1000 kg per meter cube. If these are, this is the case, if the Stokes law is valid and this is the equation, ut is equal to dp square into rho p minus rho l into g by 18 times mu. Let us substitute each and every value and put the units there to get a clarity. 40 into 10 power minus 6 meters, this is square, diameter the square into rho p 2600 minus 1000, which is kg per meter cube, and g is 9.8 meter per second square, and the 18 times the viscosity of the liquid, 18 into 10 power minus 3 kg per meter second. By calculating, we got what is the velocity at which the particle is coming down, 0.0014 meter per second. That's the very slightest speed it is coming down, because I mean, in reality also the particle size is, because the 40 micron, which is small particles which come down at a very lower velocity, is because the gravity on them is very low. Similarly, the same example, if we solve for the Newton's law regime, calculate the terminal settling velocity of the particle if the falls in the Newton's regime. Similarly, we have to take the Newton's law to calculate the terminal settling velocity. That is 1.75 into square root times gp in rho p minus rho l by rho l. If I substitute everything in this particular equation, I get 0.043 meters per second. So this is how the terminal velocity, terminal settling velocity of the particle is calculated. I hope you have learned something, and I'll come back with a new video.